In this video, I'm going to show how to draw the structure of nephron and we will discuss the function of its parts. Nephron is a structural and functional unit of the kidney. There are about 1 to 1.5 million nephrons present in each kidney. The nephron has distinct parts. It has a cup-shaped structure which extends to form a tubule, a convoluted thick tubule which descends down, and as it descends it becomes thinner. This thin tubule then coils upward and ascends to form again a thick structure which then joins with the collecting tubules. The cup-shaped structure shows the blood capillaries entering inside. So these are the arterioles that branch from the renal artery that enter inside the kidneys. These arterioles, once it enters inside the glomerulus to form a network, it comes out and then forms branches around the tubules that are present, that is the thick tubules that are present. These coil around and form a highly dense network of capillaries along the entire length of the tubules. This capillaries helps in reabsorption of water as well as other substances from the filtrate, and finally they move towards the renal vein. This completes with the drawing of the nephron. Now let us label the parts. So here the first part is the arteriole that enters inside the malphigian corpuscle, that is the cup-shaped structure. So this is called as the efferent arteriole. The efferent arteriole carries blood into the network of capillaries in the cup-shaped structure and it moves out as the efferent arteriole. The cup-shaped structure has got a network or a tuft of capillaries which is called as the glomerulus. The glomerulus is present inside the cup-shaped structure which is called as the Bowman's capsule. So the glomerulus and the Bowman's capsule together forms the malphigian corpuscle or the malphigian body. This structure is responsible for ultrafiltration. So the blood gets filtered in this part. The next part is a thick tubule which is convoluted, and that is called as a proximal convoluted tubule. The proximal convoluted tubule is the region where maximum reabsorption of substances takes place as well as maximum amount of water is reabsorbed in this region. The distal part of the tubule is called as a distal convoluted tubule, which also helps in certain amount of reabsorption and mainly secretion. The region between these two, that is the proximal and the distal convoluted tubule, forms the loop of Henle. The proximal convoluted tubule moves down to form the descending limb of loop of Henle, which then forms a turn which is called as the hairpin bend of the loop of Henle, to then move upward to form the ascending limb of loop of Henle. The loop of Henle is mainly concerned with reabsorption of water. So here the descending limb of loop of Henle is highly permeable to water, hence water moves out from this region and is taken back by the capillaries, whereas the ascending limb of loop of Henle is impermeable to water and only allows the salts to move. The blood vessel that surrounds the loop of Henle is called as the vasa recta, and the blood vessel that surrounds the proximal and the distal convoluted tubules forms the peritubular capillary, or it is also called as the secondary capillaries. The filtrate that is formed in the proximal convoluted tubule moves through the tubule into the loop of Henle, where reabsorption happens, and after that the secretion happens in the distal convoluted tubule. After all this, the filtrate is now called as urine, which passes through the collecting ducts.